Hello and welcome to week five. For week five, first you're going to complete your reading assignment. You'll read section 7 in chapter 5 and section 5 in chapter 8 in Let's Get Writing. You also have a PowerPoint that will guide you through the visual definition a little bit in a little more detail, as well as a pronouns PowerPoint. So once you've gone through all of those, move on to the criteria for the visual definition. What you're going to do is you're going to think about an issue that faces all of our communities, whether rural or urban or suburban, and that issue is homelessness. You can choose whatever end of the spectrum you want to develop a particular definition on. So here's some words below that you can build into a definition argument. So you're arguing for the meaning of the word according to you, and you're going to build that with images, perhaps video, definitely sound and color, as well as text. So what I did down in this example here is just walk you through, if I were to be defining the word teenager, what types of characteristics I might focus on and build so that you overall have an understanding. And don't forget that all of the types of writing that we've done so far this semester can be used as ways to build a definition, things like comparison or things like narration. And then in a little bit more kind of sequential format, you'll want to think about, your first frame should be you, the author, as well as a title for this particular word. You're going to think about the term that you are defining and introducing that to your viewer. But I would suggest being creative and straying away from just a Merriam-Webster definition of the word. Think about in the next few frames, and remember, this has to be about a minute to 2 minutes long. So, it may take, another 10, 15 frames. It really depends on you and what you're developing in each of those. But you want to think about just different ways that you can help us as viewers understand this word, especially, again, you're arguing for its meaning according to what you think this word means. And then you'll creatively reinforce that term as you close. You'll include a credits. The credits can be more or less general. All images from Google Images, the name of the song and the artist. If you've used video, you could just put the links to the YouTube videos in there. But again, giving credit where credit is due. And then you'll also include a written reflection. And that written reflection will be a one-page essay that answers the 6 questions below. So think about, what it'll take you to, what kind of time it will take you to develop the visual definition as well as the essay. Both of those are due to the video presentation submission link by Sunday. And then also you'll submit the link to your video to the discussion forum number 5. So again, kind of planning out your week. All of these are due on Sunday, but you'll want to, pace yourself as usual. All right, so both link and written reflection go to the video presentation link. The discussion forum number 5, you'll post the link to your video and you'll comment on 2 fellow students' videos. But remember, this isn't a peer review, so you don't want to give them constructive criticism because they aren't going to be revising it. Maybe you'll comment on what you learned about the issue or a part of the definition that resonates with you. And then another thing that's up in our review section are some examples of visual definitions. Not all of them are perfect, but they give you a wide range of ways that you can put this together. So it's just something to get those, those kind of organizational thoughts moving in advance of creating your own visual definition. And then finally, don't forget to take your grammar and usage checkpoint number 5 before the end of the week. Again, you'll want to pace yourself so that you get everything done on time. If you have questions, let me know.